This is Jamie.
What? Who said that?
Nobody.
Meh. Okay.
Jamie is a typical kid. Jamie likes playing games. Jamie likes talking to friends.
And so I'm like, no way. And she's all, whatever. And I'm like, you did not just say that. Am I right?
And sometimes, Jamie has to do tricky homework.
Yeah. Ugh.
Jamie is just like you. But one morning, Jamie noticed something strange.
Hang on a minute. Something seems unusual. Aha! I've grown taller. No, that's not it. I have two eyes. No, I've always had those.
Then suddenly, Jamie realized.
I've lost my hair! No.
Jamie searched high and low for the missing hair.
Hair! 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 Hello, police? Yes, I'd like to report a theft. Well, I think someone stole my hair. What's so funny? No, it's not a joke. Stop laughing.
The police suggested to go and speak to a doctor. So Jamie did just that.
You have alopecia areata. Jamie?
Is it... where?
Alopecia areata.
Oh, no thanks. I'm not hungry.
No, that's the condition you have. That's why your hair's gone.
Oh! Alopecia areata.
Alopecia areata.
Aha. Agronesia alabertha.
Alopecia areata.
Akaloha apalfalfa.
Listen to me say it. Alopecia areata.
Alopecia areata.
That's it.
Ha! What's that?
Well, alopecia areata is a condition where you lose your hair. Sometimes people lose all the hair on their body, but it affects everybody in different ways.
Alopecia is just where your hair follicles fall out, because the rest don't like you.
I have alopecia areata universalis, so total loss of all hair.
I first was diagnosed with alopecia where all of my hair fall out, like my eyelashes and my eyebrows. And then it started growing back in patches. And then it started like falling out, then growing back again.
I think it's alopecia totalis.
I have universal alopecia. That's when I lose hair all over my body. I can't quite remember.
So that's what alopecia areata means. Jamie?
I was really scared that I was going to die, and I was terrified that what if I gave it to my sister? She had such pretty hair. But I was mostly just scared and confused.
I was a bit upset that I didn't have any hair.
I was really shocked and... because I didn't know what was happening to me.
I felt, as I was only six, I felt really surprised and like a bit angry with myself for, I don't know why, because I couldn't blame anybody or didn't know what happened and stuff.
Stay back, doctor!
Jamie, it's not contagious. Nobody can catch it from you.
Oh. Well then, how did I get it?
We don't really know. It just happens sometimes. It's really quite common.
It is?
Yeah. Many people all around the world have alopecia areata.
Wow. How many? 50?
Way more than that.
100?
No.
Thousands?
Millions.
Wow, that's way more than 50.
Mm-hmm.
Well, one day my mum was brushing my hair, and then when she brushed it, like, heaps came out, and then when I slept, there was like a ball of hair. So we went to the doctors, and yeah, he told us I had alopecia.
Every time when I wake up, there'd be hair, little pieces of fluff hair on my pillow.
My mum looked at the back of my head, and I had a, like someone had just shaved a little circle out of the back of my head, and it developed over the years.
At school, everyone called me Multi, because I was molting. And then I came home and told Mum, and so I pulled out my hair, and she didn't know what to do.
So you're saying there are thousands of kids out there with alopecia areata?
You bet.
Ah. Does their hair ever come back?
Sometimes it does, and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it grows back, and then it falls out again. But there are plenty of things you can do to cope with your hair loss, Jamie. You can talk to people, you can try medications, and there are lots of other things you can do too.
Like what?
Let me show you.
The doctor showed Jamie lots of different wigs, scarves, and hats. Some of them looked pretty cool. Some of them didn't.
Yeah.
When I go to school, I wear a wig.
I used to wear bandanas and I wore a wig for a while.
In the summer, I wear a cap and winter in the beanie.
But doctor, what if I don't want to wear anything on my head?
That's fine, Jamie. You can do whatever you like. There's no right or wrong way to deal with alopecia areata. The most important thing is that you tell your family, friends, and teachers how it makes you feel and what they can do to help. And remember, it doesn't change who you are.
Nah. Thanks, doctor.
I'd say be yourself and just tell them. Tell people if they ask what you want to tell them.
It's just alopecia, it's nothing you can catch, it's just normal.
It's not killing your body or anything. It's just where all your hair falls out and you're gonna be fine.
It doesn't actually change my experience, what I know and what I like.
It doesn't really affect my life.
Well, now I realise that my family and friends have supported me through it. I feel a bit better about myself.
I would say it's okay to be scared, but everyone will always still love you.
I can still sing, I can still draw, I can still play with my dog, I can still do all the things I love. Having no hair hasn't impacted that in any way.
Jamie still likes playing games. Jamie still likes talking to friends.
So then I'm like, I don't think so. And he's all, deal with it. And I'm like, whatevs. Am I right?
And Jamie still has to do that tricky homework. Yes, Jamie is still an ordinary kid. Just like you. Well, almost.
Hang on a minute! Something seems weird. I'm a puppet!